varsity, whatever you want to call them. So if Platteville can catch and throw low and transition, we should be good. But we'll see how that goes. Good block by JT Warren in number 34 on the left side of the screen there. By both teams. Caleb, to your right, back right. Sorry if when I yell it's loud, just trying to help my team. So UNL currently does not have a count, and by count, I mean shot clock, like in basketball. So it's the new rule, it's only you have to have two. If you have two or less balls, you don't have a shot, or you don't have a count. So now they have a count because they have three balls, no matter how many players you have. We don't like the rule as much, so we're trying to use and abuse it and to get rid of it. Team throw by Caleb and Jared. I think balls may have flighted in midair or something. Oh, that was a nice catch attempt by number 29 of UNL. I don't know his name. Another nice catch by UNL. Seth, back left. Seth, two behind you on either side. Behind you, Seth. Kyle, on either side of you. Good block by Jalen. Oh. Jalen, to your right. Seven, That is 1 point for UNL. So we'll reset and do it again. There's 20 minutes left in the first half. There are 25-minute halves for a total of 50 minutes of a game. And they're off. Oh. Nice little throw by Alex Cuddy. That's what we need to get the UNL players out because they can catch. Alex Ebert. Yeah, no, Adam. I am so sorry. Ebert with the almost out. That was very good on his part. Team throw happening on the right side here. Oh. We use those pump fakes to get him out. Team throw happening. Ooh. Going for Seth, but he stayed in. Good job, Seth. Just Nick 34 on UNL. Good out. Jacob getting that out. Oh, he got another one. One in. Someone come in. Alex, ball to the left. Oh, right in the bread basket. Throw is happening. So now UNL is down to a 10 count because they only have 5 players in. Say if they get a catch and get someone in, it would go back up to a 15 count. Thank you. Good catch by UNL.
Kyle, behind you!
Nebraska must have got a team catch at some point to have that many people in, or just a regular catch. I'm not sure. Jared with his cannon. Oh. So now Platteville has a 10 count. Now they have a 10 count. Dodgeball, the hits that, or the times you get hit that hurts the most is when you're the shagger or you're out standing on the side because you're not paying attention as much. And sometimes they'll just nail you. Good catch by number 34. And it is Jared, our lone survivor for. Ball's over on Platteville. So, we didn't throw within our allotted time, so they now get the balls, and Jared is going to hopefully catch one. So, they're going to run up and basically go firing squad on Jared, so... Jared's trying to make himself a hard target to hit. Impressive job by Jared, not... the end of the second point, I think. So, good job, Jared, for doing that. That's a tough situation when you get into. So, and we'll just do it again. Chat. Not much time left, that's all I know. Jared wants a kill. He's not too happy about the ending of that last point. Good out. I don't know who threw 96 out, but that was a good out. Holy cow! Amazing catch by number 28. He got out, but that was impressive. Got out by a ball that came and hit him afterwards. Platteville only has two balls right now, so we don't have a count. That's the second time they've just nicked a finger or a shoulder to get two of our players out now, so. Okay, good, we're back, I think. Yep. It was reconnecting for a second. I'm commentating, don't worry. Okay, good, we're back. Sorry about that. Technical difficulties is what we'll call that. Poor wireless connection is what it said, so. We're gonna, hopefully that doesn't happen again, but. Getting some team throws in here. Team throw just. Part of the team throw in more than one person. Good block by JT. Good block by Alex Cuddy. Number 32. Good throw by JT getting the foot of 28. It just goes to show you always have to be watching. Platteville gets some catches in. That'd be amazing. Good catch by number 8. Grab the high ground. Cody, to your right. Larson get in and out. Good throw by Cody Larson, bounced off the foot and going into the bleachers. Go, Cody, go! Okay, that's an official's timeout right now because Cody threw a ball. Then the UNL guy caught it, but then afterwards Cody caught a ball. So I am not sure on the official ruling of that from the rule books. We'll find out momentarily. He is out and doesn't bring anyone in, sadly. Wish it worked like that, but... oh well.
Five minutes left in the half. So,
JT trying to get a catch, but unable to. A good attempt on him. He did all he could. He had his arms out and ready. Sorry I didn't show that to you. Really should have, but... so there's 4 minutes left in the half. Sorry if we hear any swear words. I know the mouse is my teammate, so just be aware of that. And they're off once again. We got one out at the beginning. They got one out at the beginning. It's sad, but it happens. Good block by Caleb Newell, number 7. Oh, jeez. Caleb and Kyle both getting pegged.
JT, back left. Nick, back left.
Yep.
Okay, I'm back now. Sorry, I had to go grab my battery pack because the battery pack plugged into the phone died. So the phone was at 20%. I'm assuming there was a balls over on UNL. One in, yeah. Alex Cuddy with the catch, getting Caleb Newland. Let's go. We need more of those catches. Oh! A catch by JT Warren! Good job, JT. Bringing Kyle in. Caleb Newell going up. Caden, bottom right, and if going for the catch, that's what we like to see. Sorry if you guys can hear the announcer. Not sure what he's. There's badminton going on the other courts, I think. Not sure what it is exactly, though. So sorry if you guys can hear that. that's the end of the game. Well, half, not the game. That's the end of the half. So we will take a 5-minute break here. The video will, I'm assuming, continue rolling. Is there a... Maybe. I don't think it's half. I have no timeout or something. I have no clue what's going on. 30 seconds till the half, so... One catch by JT Warren. And that's first half. So we will be back in 5 minutes. The live will continue rolling. So each team is going to talk and then we'll get back at it.
Eric, you want me down there? Do you want me to stay up here or come down? Okay. Leave it going.
3-0 Nebraska as we come to the second half. Into the second half, 10 players for each team. Shortly into the second half, 3-0 Nebraska. It is 10 players versus 4 for UWP. Catch for Nebraska. Another catch for Nebraska. It is now 6 players for Platteville and 4 for Nebraska. Players versus 5 players. Nebraska is up 3-0. Apologize, the phone is on 10% battery and I don't know how to charge it. So if this cuts out, I apologize. is now 3-1. Nebraska still has the lead. So the phone said it was on 10% battery, so I switched it to this one, but I don't know.
Is it charging?
I don't know if it's charging.
I'll go get the...
to go. Nebraska still has a 3-1 lead. Comfortable lead, if you ask me. Captains just got out.
You can use, or if you want to just use the cord and hold it.
I just don't know how to tell if it's charging.
Is it the charger itself?
I don't know.
What's it at?
I don't know. All I saw was that there was a warning at 10%, and that was what I've seen so far. Eight players for Nebraska, 7 for Platteville.
That away, Cody!
7 players for each team.
Yeah!
catch for Nebraska. Seven again. Correction. 7-5 Nebraska. Five Nebraska. Five v five. Just want to keep playing this unit if we win this point.
I'm okay. Are you good with that?
Yeah.
They're just playing well. I don't want to.
Yep. Don't want to ruin it. Good out thrown by number 8 of Nebraska. 5 players for Nebraska, 4 for Platteville. Catch caught by 32, Alex Cuddy. Players for Platteville, 3 for Nebraska. Appears to be a ball's over, but we'll find out in a moment.
Ball's over. It's fine. Just let it. Is it charging or can you tell? It's just that it only has a little power left. But
well, it hasn't died on us yet, yeah. So hopefully it's charging.
Okay, well, if it does, this is an own product. This is own. There's a little power left in it. So
okay.
Plug it in, and maybe it's just that this will actually work now, okay? Make sure I don't forget this.
Yep.
Give me that cord. That way I'll
do you want it. Me to, if we do win this point, do you want me to head down if we're looking like we'll win another one?
Let me. I think we might do that, but. Same time. I don't know if I'm just
playing
out the
yeah.
third night. I just
no, I'm saying like it looks like we'd win a third point.
Oh,
in
yeah,
two.
Yeah, we'll have you come down. Yeah. 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 No,
okay. Three players for Nebraska, 5 players for Platteville. Captain Robin is in for Nebraska. Captain JT is in for Platteville. All 4 throws missed the mark. Captain JT Warren, 4-2 Platteville. Nebraska has a 3-1 lead. players for Platteville, two for Nebraska. Three players for Platteville, one for Nebraska. Nebraska still has a 3-1 lead. Ball's over. I don't know the exact time, but I'd assume there's about 8 minutes left in the half. It appears as though there might be a simultaneous balls over. In which case, I believe each team gets 5 balls. Minutes and 30 seconds, they say. Nebraska still has a 3-1 lead. Platteville has 3 players, and Nebraska has 1 right now. With the new rule, Nebraska does not have a count right here. Platteville just won that point. Nebraska still has a 3-2 lead, and there's about 7 minutes to go. I think that might be the first point that nobody got out on the start.